In this two-part video series, I will show you how to create a super bright LED panel whose pure white and warm white LEDs can be dimmed individually through control circuits that can also easily be powered by a lithium-ion battery pack. Due to its all-metal design and its quick-release plate sockets, it is also suitable for outdoor uses. So let's not waste any more time and let's get started with the mechanical build. The LED strip that I began this project with was a pure white 5630 LED strip with a nominal voltage of 12 volts. The important thing to know about those 5630 SMD LEDs is that in comparison to more common 3528 LEDs and 5050 LEDs, they feature a light output, aka luminous flux, 2 to 6 times higher than the other two, but also easily draw 2 to 6 times more current. That means even though they are the brightest of the bunch, they also heat up the most, which decreases their forward voltage and increases the current draw, and thus over time decreases their lifespan. To fix that, we would need to attach the LED strip on a metal heatsink, so that the temperature stays constant as well as the current draw. That is why an aluminum plate with a height of 30 cm, a width of 40 cm, and a thickness of 2 mm will be the first main component. Additionally, I got myself two pieces of flat bar aluminum with a length of 1 meter and dimensions of 2 cm by 1 cm. I started off by marking two 30 cm pieces and two 38 cm pieces with a scriber, and afterwards secured the material to my workbench with a clamp. Through the help of a simple metal saw, it was pretty easy to cut through the soft metal, but as a reminder, it is always possible to remove excess material later on, so always leave a safety gap. Once all the four pieces were created, I assembled them to a square shape on top of the aluminum plates, only to realize that the flat bars were a bit too long and uneven at the ends. So I used the file in combination with a bit of patience to create the required lengths and simultaneously polished the ends. Afterwards, the square shape fitted decently onto the plates. So I continued by marking two spots in the middle of the two shorter bar pieces with a distance of 8.6 cm from the outer edges. Those measurements were given by the stainless steel handles that I picked up from my local hardware store beforehand. The longer bar pieces though also received two markings, each 6.5 cm from the left and right edge. After creating indentations at the markings with a prick punch, I used them as a guide to drill through the material 8 times with a 4mm drill bit. Additionally, I used a countersink to create an indentation around the screw holes, so that my utilized screw type could sit flush with the surface. Once I was certain that the handle screw holes matched well with the newly created holes, I aligned the square pieces at the edges of the aluminum plates and used them as a template to create markings with the 4mm drill bits onto the plates. I used those markings as a guide to completely drill through the plates and afterwards mounted all the flat bar pieces temporarily to it with M4 screws and nuts. The result so far looked rather decent, so I continued by removing the long bottom piece, created a marking and indentation in the exact center of the material, and used an 8mm drill bit to create a hole there. With the help of a 3/8 inch tap set, I created a thread inside the hole, which I used to mount a 3/8 inch to 1/4 inch adapter, which is mandatory to attach the quick release plates. But before reattaching the bottom piece though, I used a bit of Loctite on the adapter threads to secure it permanently. Next, I removed the two shorter bars in order to create two indentations on each, in the middle of them, 5mm away from both their outer edges. By using a 3.2mm drill bit, I created four holes where the indentations used to be, and remounted the flat bars back onto the plates. This way, I now have guiding holes for the 3.2mm drill bits that needs to enter the following material for 1.5 cm. By using an electric drill, a steady hand, and a bit of brute force, I created the four holes in the longer square pieces. Afterwards, I removed the shorter bars once again, used an M4 tap set to create threads in the longer pieces, and extended the 3.2mm holes of the shorter pieces to 4mm and countersank their top screw holes. After remounting the removed pieces to the plates for the 100th time, it was now an easy task to use shorter M4 screws to link the square pieces together and thus increase their structural integrity. The last missing component for this build was a piece of acrylic glass, the milky white kind to be precise, with these measurements. Not only will it protect the LEDs, but also diffuse their light significantly. So I drew a rectangle with a distance of 5mm from the edges onto the piece of acrylic glass and marked the middle points on the shorter sides and two points 13cm from the left and right edge onto the two longer sides. Through the help of a 2.5mm drill bit, I created 6 holes in the acrylic glass corresponding to the markings, placed it on top of the metal construction and used it just like a template to mark the spots for the required holes in the flat bar pieces. So finally, for the last time, I had to remove all the metal square pieces in order to drill the 6 2.5mm holes through the aluminum and then used an M3 tap set to create a thread inside those holes. But while reattaching the square pieces though, this time I utilized the previously mentioned handles for the shorter pieces and M4 self-locking nuts for the longer pieces. The only thing left to do was to enlarge the previously created 2.5mm holes of the acrylic glass to 3mm, remove its protective film, and shorten the length of the M4 screws at the back of the aluminum plates. At this point, we could use small M3 screws to attach the acrylic glass to the metal construction and thus finish the mechanical build. But since we still need to place the LEDs inside the panel and wire it all up, we might as well leave it open for part 2. Until then, don't forget to like, share and subscribe. That would be awesome. Stay creative and I will see you next time with part 2.